كنتم فؤادي ورب العباد، وأنتم منائي وأقصى المراد.
فهل تسعدوني بصفو؟
أيوب عليه السلام. Ayyub alayhi salam, he had 14 children and he had great health and wealth. Everybody loved him. One day after 80 years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took away all of his 14 children, one by one. Then he took away his wealth. Then he took away his health until the narration says that his skin used to fall off his body until you could see his muscles and his bones. And he's still alive, breathing. Not only that, the people began to say, if this man was a good person, Allah wouldn't have done this to him. So he lost his close friends. One day his wife came in and said, Ya Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, isn't it enough now? Can't you ask Allah to get rid of this? It's enough. We've gone through too much. Ayyub alayhi salam then said, my wife, how long did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me blessings for? She said, 80 years or so. He said, I am too shy to ask Allah to cure me yet until 80 years of this time has gone as well. Because given me so much. It was after 7 years, however, when he saw his wife resorted to taking from her hair and selling it, that he said, Rabbi, Masani al-Durru wa anta arhamur rahim. Even look at the way that Prophet, he asked Allah to cure him. He didn't say, oh Allah, cure me. Oh Allah, you have harmed me. Oh Allah, you brought this sickness, take it away from me. No, no, no. He said, oh my Lord, harm has afflicted me. He didn't even attribute it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when harm comes to a Muslim, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala afflicts you with some kind of hardship, it's actually good for you. وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِيمِينَ. And you are the most merciful. Allah says, فَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِ مِنْ ضُرٍ. We took away all the harm away from him. وَآتَيْنَاهُ أَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ. We gave him his family back and his children back and double their amount. We gave him wealth. Grasshoppers, like the shape of grasshoppers of gold, began to rain onto Ayyub alayhi salam. Used to pick him up. It's in the hadith, it says that he would go around and picking as much as he can so quickly. And then Allah sent Jibreel alayhi salam and said to him, Ya Ayyub, are you not already being given enough blessings? Why are you trying to hog everything up? Don't worry, we're giving you blessings. Why are you so quick in wanting to gather it all? He said, Ya Rab, who is there that can take enough of your ni'mah, enough of your blessings? I'm gathering your blessing, Ya Rab. So a Muslim, Allah loves to see his servant taking from his blessing. He loves it. And thanking Allah for his blessing. The Prophet ﷺ said, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ فَإِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلُّهُ خَيْرٌ. Strange is the matter of the believer. For anything that happens to him or her is good. SubhanAllah. He said, إِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ شَكَرٌ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءٌ صَبَرٌ. When something good happens to them, they thank Allah. When something bad happens to them, they are patient. There are people who make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they call upon Allah, call and call and call, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't yet respond. So what do? They say, I've asked Allah and I've asked Allah and He hasn't listened to me. I don't want to ask Him anymore. The Prophet ﷺ warned and he said, a person may ask Allah and Allah would not give him. When he's just about to give him, he says, I'm sick and tired of this. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was testing him because he loves to hear his servant call upon him night and day and in order to give him so much in the hereafter. Ikhwan, for those who understand Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will know that when you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you go through a bit of hardship, Allah loves to hear your voice night and day. Why? On the day of judgment, He will say to those who didn't, my servant will take this and that and that and that and that. Why, Ya Rabbi? He will say, because my servant kept calling upon me and this is why he has earned what I have given him. Allah wants to give you more and He will give you in the end, don't worry, in this life.